Hello, y'all. Good morning. Welcome to my channel. If you're new here, welcome back. If you aren't, my name is Lauren and I am a first year, first grade teacher. But anyways, today is Tuesday, May 5th. So it's also Cinco de Mayo. Happy Cinco de Mayo if you honor that holiday. Happy Teachers Appreciation Week. I appreciate all of you teachers that are here in this space. You guys are awesome. And all of your advice has really helped me in my first year. So thank you. But anyways, that is a Tuesday, which means it is a work day. And I have an absurd amount of energy today, but that's okay. It's all good. I'm still gonna go have coffee and make breakfast, and then we are getting to work, and I'm gonna take you guys through my day today. I have a lot of exciting things planned, and I'm excited for you to see it. So without further ado, let's go get started. I just realized that I did not show you guys my outfit today, so I'm going to do that quickly before I head over there and make my coffee. But anyways, I'm wearing my pink tassel earrings. These are from the Jane app and they're very old, so I don't think you can find the exact same pair. But if you do search tassel earrings on Amazon, there's a bunch of them, and I actually have a set that's linked to my storefront. They're not exactly the same, but they're very similar. And then I am wearing my new shirt. And I am so excited. This is from Teach, Create, Motivate. And I have wanted the camo and tie-dye in this design for a long time, but I always would like miss the launches when she would have pre-orders available in my size. And so I finally got it and I love it. I'm just wearing my little camo shirt, leggings, and then, oh, it's really bright down there so you can't see them. Here, I'll take one off. I have new slippers. They're not new. I just haven't been wearing them because it's actually been like really cold here, so I couldn't wear them because they don't cover your little toesies. But these are from Target. They were in the kid section, but I got a large, so they fit. And I'm pretty sure, I don't think anyone has ever like mentioned that or commented on that in my videos, but I'm a pretty little gal, so kid section works for me. But anyways, they're probably not online anymore because they are old. Okay, coffee time. Alrighty, here is my coffee. I have been following this same recipe from, I think, two vlogs ago when I made this every day, and it just gets better and better. I have not gotten sick of this, so I literally have it every day. But I've realized that if you let it sit for a little while and kind of let the whipped coffee part on the top sit down into the milk, it kind of, one, it looks really pretty, but it kind of does the same thing that like a caramel macchiato would do at Starbucks, where the espresso or the coffee mixes itself into the milk before you stir it and just makes it a little bit easier to stir. So I'm gonna let this sit and I'm going to cook my breakfast. Alrighty, you guys, I got my breakfast. Two eggs on toast. I have my hot sauce here. I just haven't put it on there yet. You guys know me. And I wanted to show you my coffee. This is what it starts to look like after it's sat for about 8 minutes or so. And you can see that the coffee is starting to integrate itself into the milk. So it just makes it a lot easier to stir it up before I sip it. So look how cute. But anyway, it's breakfast time. And then it is time to get to work. You guys, I just sat down at my desk to get started responding to emails and parents and everything, and I checked my email and our admin sent us a $10 gift card to Amazon, which is so exciting. I have been getting a lot of things from Amazon, as I'm sure you guys have, especially things that aren't like food items, because I don't feel that those are like essential trips. If I remember things I need while I'm at the store, I grab them, of course, but I've been buying books for read alouds and classroom materials since I can't get into my classroom. You guys know that. So I am so excited to have a little special gift card in my inbox this morning just to let us know that they appreciate us. And it's just so nice. I've never had a Teacher Appreciation Week before, obviously, because it's my first year. So any appreciation makes my heart explode. I'm way too happy this morning. I'm sorry. But anyways, I'm sitting here. I'm getting started responding to emails. I have some parent messages to respond to. And all of our work, I just want to like preface the next statement with this. All of our work in Massachusetts is considered optional. It's not to like affect the student's grade at all. So with that being said, said, I have had like quite a few students and families who are going through some very extenuating circumstances with everything going on in the world right now, and they've kind of been opting out. And I just got an email from a parent who said that they would really love to get on track now. They kind of have the time and the headspace to get back into the swing of things. So I am so, so happy for this student. And I really, really hope that the child comes to our meeting today, because I know that his friends would be so happy to see him. So anyways, a bunch of good news. Ah, what a day. Okay, guys, I am going to get started responding to some emails, and I will touch bases with y'all soon. Smiling so big today because I just checked our Boom Learning reports for this week's work, and I have three kiddos who have not logged into Boom Learning to do any of the assignments with 100% and 96% in assignments from this week. So that means that more of them are participating, and that just makes my heart soar. I am so excited, you guys. What a good day. Oh my goodness, and it's only gonna get better. Wow, okay, back to work. So yesterday for our SEL component, this week's theme is self-regulation and awareness of your own emotions and regulation of emotions that might be overwhelming you. So anyways, yesterday for our little SEL check-in at the end of the day, I created a Google form, and this is a, I don't even want to say selfish, but it's a mildly selfish thing to include in this form. I left a little like chat box for them to type to me, and I just said, well, most of the form is like, how are you feeling today? Let me just show it to you. It says, how are you feeling today? I wrote, you have made it through 7 weeks of online learning. Wow, how are you feeling about it all? And I said, write a message or question to Miss Barner. That's the selfish part. And then, how are you feeling today with a scale of like emojis? And then they just chose the one that they agreed with. And the pink is on top of the world. That's like the top of the scale. And then I'll just read them down. On top of the world, great, pretty good, so-so, not so good, or I need to talk to someone. And then they just choose the one they want and they submit the form. But I just want to read you guys the responses for the short answer part. Okay, I say selfish because that honestly has very little to do with their SEL regulation, unless they do need to talk to someone, in which case that would be a great place to ask me a question or to let me know that they are struggling. But a lot of them write nice little things to me, and it just makes my heart explode. So maybe I'll do this once a week. But anyways, one of them said, hi, Miss Barnard from their name. And then one says, I miss you, Miss Barnard. I miss you, Jill. And then one says, I enjoyed the read aloud and I miss you. And then, hi, Miss Barnard. I'm feeling pretty good. I miss you. You guys, you have to do one of these Google forms just to get some little notes from your kids. They literally will just make you so happy. Oh my gosh, I'm so glad I checked that. Oh, and I also just printed, I wonder if you can see it. Let me see if I can turn you. Over here, I have like a wall calendar, and this is the PDF that I send to families on Monday with all of our learning assignments in it. But I like to print one on cardstock and just have it right there at the bottom. There's like a little strip of corkboard, just so that when I am like checking their assignments and things, I can just quickly look and I know what exactly they're supposed to have done by now. Because I normally assign between like 7 and 8 Boom decks a week, and I can look in assignments, but then it's like easier for me to just see like, okay, it's Wednesday, so they should have by now completed these four. And then I can just see the reports for those four instead of like clicking all of them and trying to figure it out and remember in my head. And I have the file on my computer, but I'm a hard copy person, so I have it right there. I just printed that out. So there's that. I am just finished checking those forms, which is why I'm so excited. And I'm looking at Boom, and I am floored, you guys, because we did not learn time yet, like during the school year. Following our district pacing guide, telling time to the hour and half hour came like kind of at the end of the year, along with like data and measurement. We hadn't done any of those yet, and I was very apprehensive about teaching time online, because I know that as a student, I really liked to have the clock manipulatives to move the hands myself and understand like how they turn. And I had a full class set of clocks in my classroom. Obviously, can't go there. I've told you guys that before, but I do not want to buy that many clocks again. So I found an app online. It is through mathlearningcenter.org/math-clock. I'll link it down below, but it is amazing. I used it to do a digital learning lesson on telling time to the hour, and it was the first time I had introduced it, but I talked about the minute hand and the hour hand, and that one's shorter, one's longer. That's how you tell them apart. But I talked about an analog clock is round. It has the numbers around the edges, and the hands help us to figure out what time it is. This is the minute hand. This is the hour hand. When we tell time to the hour, the minute hand is always pointing straight up to the number 12 to show that no minutes have passed yet. We use the word o'clock after the number to tell us that it is exactly on the hour. Wherever the hour hand is pointing tells us what hour of the day it is. So anyways, I did this little like online learning lesson. Maybe I'll insert a clip of that here. Today, we are going to start exploring the clock. We are going to learn how to tell time to the hour. So right here, I have a clock on my screen that I can move to show some different times. But what's most important is that we first learn about the different parts of this clock. You'll see that the clock here is round with two hands and numbers around the outside. This clock is called an analog clock. Say that with me. Analog clock. You got it. Okay, so there's a little tidbit of like the lessons that I send out. But anyways, then I assigned some Boom decks for telling time to the hour. We did one yesterday, and then the one yesterday, it had an analog clock, and then it had digital clocks showing three times, and they chose the one that matched the analog clock. And then the one today is a little bit different. I'm not quite sure. I think they type the time today. I think that's how it's different. But I am so happy and like pleasantly surprised, because introducing a skill over digital learning is new for me. And I'm looking at these reports and I see 96%, 98%, 100%, 100%, 96, 100. The lowest score I've had on either of these assignments is an 88. Which is incredible. I am so, so proud of them and happy. And I have been texting parents like, I just noticed that so-and-so got a 100 on their very first attempt at telling time to the hour. Please give them a big high five from Miss Barnard. Like, I am so excited. Okay, anyways, sorry, you guys. I feel like I'm like, I don't know. This must be like what it's like to take drugs. I don't know. I'm like really excited today. Okay, anyways, I'm gonna keep working, but yeah, great news. Alrighty, y'all, it is now about 11:20, and I have just been responding to parent emails, responding to staff emails, just checking out what my kids have been doing in Boom, and then I also was finishing up and posting today's doodle for Teacher Appreciation Week. So if you don't follow me on Instagram, let me explain what I mean. For Teacher Appreciation Week, I have been, well, it's only been 2 days, but my plan is to post a doodle every day to celebrate a teacher online that I really appreciate, that has made an impact in my career so far, or that just really uplifts me. So yesterday I shared this doodle of Maddie and just wrote what I appreciate and how she's helped my teaching career. And then today I just finished up and shared this doodle, and this is actually of Real Rap with Reynolds. He has a YouTube channel as well, which is mostly like where I have I guess like interacted with him, you would say, or like followed along with him is a better word for it. But anyways, I just really appreciate his wisdom that he shares in his videos and how open he is about teaching as a profession. He is someone who I would look to as like an expert in teaching. Even though he teaches high school and I teach first grade, it's just nice to follow someone who intentionally mentors younger teachers. So anyways, this is my doodle for him. Ooh, the ring light's gonna reflect in it. So anyways, I'll try as best I can. Whoa. Okay, that's what it looks like. It's just a picture from his Instagram that I took and then doodled. So I just finished that, shared that on my story. And now that it is 11:20, I wanted to kind of like catch you guys up because I'm about to have like boom, 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 meeting, meeting, meeting. So I want you to know what they're for. But anyways, from 12 to 12:30, I'm doing a live reading lesson with my kids, which is exciting because we haven't done any lessons like that in a live format. And I'm going to do screen sharing, I'm hoping, and do some like foundations, letter tiles things. So we'll see how that goes. One issue that I'm having is that I'm not sure, like, once I've started sharing my screen, how to like stop and go back to like not presenting anymore. So that'll be interesting, but we're gonna try it. And then immediately after that, so 12 to 12:30, teaching my kids, 12:30 to 1:30, I have a meeting with my grade level team, just to like touch bases, catch us up, everything else. And then right at 1:30, I am FaceTiming with Maddie at Primarily Yours on YouTube and Instagram, and Kim from Elementary and the Mitten on YouTube and Instagram, and I'm so excited! So, we have a little FaceTime date today. Three meetings back to back to back, but the good news is that my energy levels are at an all-time high, so I'm gonna be fine. But anyways, I'm gonna continue setting up for my reading lesson and deciding like how that's gonna go, what our flow will be, maybe developing a little time breakdown for it because it is only 30 minutes and I can't go over because I have a meeting. Okay, I'm a little bit out of breath, but that's okay, let's do it. Alrighty, meeting with my kiddos done. Now meeting with the other teachers and I'm already a minute late, so I'll talk to you guys later. Alrighty, you guys. Two of the three meetings done. The next one is not really a meeting. It's just FaceTiming and hanging out with Kim and Maddie. So I'm excited, but it is 1:27. So I need to not be talking to you guys so that we can FaceTime instead. So anyways, I will talk to them and then I will talk to y'all later. Okay, that is the last Zoom/FaceTime thing I had planned for today, but that was wonderful. I just hung up with Maddie and Kim. We were on FaceTime for 2 hours, actually, just like talking about things. That's weird because it literally felt like 20 minutes, but it was so fun just to like interact with them and FaceTime with them and just to see some faces that I don't see every day. So anyways, that was lovely. Now it is about 3:30 because time flew through all of those meetings and everything. So anyways, I need to eat lunch. I have not eaten lunch and your girl is a little hungry. So I am going to go make some lunch and then I think I'm gonna sit outside and maybe start a new book. I'm excited. I have like a huge stack of books from Amazon and it's just so wonderful outside and it hasn't been super warm here lately. So anyways, lunch and then some time in the sunshine before the sunshine is gone. So let's get to it. Alrighty, you guys, change of plans. It was so nice outside when we were on the stoop after I ate my salad that I decided that we were going to go for a run. We being me because Jake ran this morning, so he doesn't want to run. We went to the track at the local middle school that we normally run on, and there were too many people like to be in a lane 6 feet away from someone consistently. There were actually kind of a lot of people. So we came to this little spot around us that has stairs, and I am going to do four sets of five, up one and down the other one. And then I am going to just jog a mile around the parking lot, just as like a little afternoon workout in the sunshine. So anyways, let's get started. more to go. I'm wearing my Orange Theory monitor, so I'll let you know when I finish the next 10. Okay, you guys, workout finished. I finished 20. I was gonna do 4 sets of 5, but Jake was up here motivating me, so I did 6 and then 4 and then 7, and then it was not an even set. But anyways, it was about 16 minutes, and my Orange Theory gave me 12 squat points, which means I was in like target heart rate zones for 12 minutes of that, which is great. And I says I burned about 189 calories, although I'm always a little bit skeptical of that. But anyways, workout finished. Now we're just gonna sit here and enjoy the sun for a little while longer and then head home. Okay, we are back home now. Workout done, shower done, and now I am just going to put some clothes away, kind of tidy up in here. This is actually our guest room. Sorry, I don't know what is going on over here. Anyways, this is our guest room. This is where like I get ready in the mornings. Jake has the closet in our like master bedroom, so I use the one that's in here. So all of my like shoes and makeup and clothes and stuff are in here. So I just have some things to put away. I did some laundry, so need to hang some stuff up. And then he is actually downstairs cooking dinner, which is lovely. So then we will have dinner in a few, but for right now it's time to tidy up in here. Okay, I don't know if this is gonna be helpful or not, but I was just thinking as I was putting my clothes away, I'm wondering if like any other teachers here on YouTube or just like in life do this. So when I hang up my clothes, I have like this first section all the way to like my Florida football jersey is like personal things that I would never wear like for school. And then everything is sorted, like it goes tank tops, short sleeves, three-quarter sleeves, long sleeve sweater, sweatshirts for my personal stuff. And then here starts like my school stuff, like things that I would wear to school. And that doesn't mean I wouldn't wear those in my personal life, but there's like, you know, can't do personal life clothes at school. So anyway, so then it's like the same pattern of like dresses, tank top, short sleeves, three-quarter sleeves, long sleeves, sweaters for school stuff. And I'm wondering if other teachers do that as well. Let me know, because I'm always interested if there's like a better way that I could organize and differentiate between like my teacher clothes and my real life clothes. But anyways, everything is put away. And if you are wondering what is in this beautiful bag, it is my gown from Miss Massachusetts USA 2020 that I competed in, which was lovely. It was a wonderful experience. But if you want a picture of me in my pageant gown, maybe I'll insert one here.
Contestant number 67, Lauren.
Woo! Woo! Yes, Lauren!
Yes!
Woo!
Number 94, Insta Fernandez.
Beautiful, right? I know, I want to wear it all the time. But anyways, now it is dinner time. Dinner is done. It was delicious. We have tacos every Tuesday, so we had tacos. They were great. Good job making dinner. And now we're gonna play Uno. Fun fact, I played this a lot with my sister when I was in Florida, which is why I wanted to have this version where you can flip the deck. And so I ordered it from Amazon a while ago, I think maybe like 2 or even 3 weeks ago, and I guess it's like back ordered on Amazon. It also was a lot more expensive, and I just got very impatient because we like to play board games and card games, and I knew that we would love this one. So when I was doing my weekly grocery trip, I bought this at Target, and it was much cheaper. It was only $6, and they had a bunch of them, and this version is really fun. So if you like card games and board games and such like we do, you might like this one. But it is time to annihilate Jake in Uno. So far, my record is 1-0. Jake's record is 0-1. already. We ended up playing 4 games of Uno, so that was really fun. But now it is about 8:45, and I think that I am going to, if anything, just read for a little bit or start importing all of the clips from today to put together today's vlog. But I wanted to go ahead and, you know, wrap it up here and let you know that if you have any questions or anything, please leave them down below. I normally dedicate like the day after posting a video to really responding to like every single comment that's posted. So if you do have any questions, leave them here and I will try to get back to you. Or any like recommendations, suggestions, anything like that. You guys know I'm totally open to any of your advice, comments, whatever they are. Anyways, if you like this video and you are new here, please stick around. You can click the subscribe button if you'd like to be notified of my next videos. But other than that, thank you guys for coming and I'll see you next time.